good, everybody? This is Muskan here, sending many more smiles to you there. The content we watch either entertains us or upgrades us as a person. The graph is all yours. Today, we are launching a brand new podcast featuring Mr. Srikanth Gupta, the founder of Inspirit Institute of Communication Skills, IICS, and of course, our life coach, Skill Coach. If you're someone who's chasing to be legendary in life, if you're someone who's chasing self-growth, then this video is all yours. Enjoy yourself.
A very warm welcome to you, sir. It's an honor to meet you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Ms. Na.
Without wasting much time, because the youth is very impatient today, let's start with the question answer session. How important is it to sharpen your personality these days?
Personality plays an important role in an individual's life. If you don't upgrade and update yourself according to the demand of the world, then you will be out of the market. And this is very important. I should live my life in such a way where my personality becomes the source of inspiration. My personality becomes the source of happiness. My personality becomes the source of example for others. And how it will happen? It will happen when we will sharpen our personality. Because we cannot change the world without changing ourselves. So, sharpen the personality means sharpen somehow, in another way, contributing towards the world too.
Okay, that's an enthusiastic start for the show. So when is it exactly we think that it's time to reform, it's time to bring the transformation inside us?
Definitely. I would like to say in a beautiful way, like if you reform, like if an individual reform him or herself, if an individual reforms, a family reforms. When a family reforms, the society reforms. When the society reforms, the community reforms. When the community reforms, the country reforms. And when the country reforms, the world reforms. So if an individual reforms, one world reforms. That's the beauty. So an individual itself is a world. And that's why we call it personality grooming.
That's really beautiful to hear that you're working towards a beautiful world. You're looking a beautiful world outside. Of course, everyone who knows him, we know. Tell me the line you say millions of times in your institute. All those who know him, we already know the line. But still, for the audience who is new, so please can we hear that line?
Life is beautiful.
For sure it is.
And I would like to say, Muskan, this is now very much needed, I'm telling you, because this is the time to help the world. This is the time to help our dear and near ones to give those feelings, because they need it more. As we are living in the painful situation, everybody, means in every neighbor's house, if you see, you will find that the world is full of negativity, painful situation. We don't know even about tomorrow. We have unpredictable tomorrow. So this is the time to help each other. This is the time to connect with each other. This is the time to give hope to the people. So we must be hopeful. And to be hopeful, first we should sharpen our personality.
Oh my God, I wish everyone thinks like you in our nation, then we will be standing somewhere else. But one should be a real human being in this real world.
Definitely.
Rather being in the cocoon of Instagram and Snapchats, one should learn the skill to interact with people.
Definitely.
One should learn to live, enjoy life rather, I would say, to enjoy life with hashtag no more filters wali perfect Insta profile. Mm-hmm. Can you please teach us, let's not bother about social media much and rather we should focus on the life we are having today.
Muskan, we have come out with a new campaign and it happened all of a sudden. Your beautiful question you have asked, because this social site, this Instagram or Facebook or whatever it is killing the creativity skill of the youth especially. So we have come out with a different slogan that social media for entertainment, everybody does, everybody knows, but let social media for the part of enlightenment and creativity, where we begin. And the more time you give to yourself, believe me, the more energetic you will be, the more productive you will be, the more happy you will be, the more peaceful you will be, and the same environment you will be able to bring to your family too. That's the beauty. That's the beauty. If you are responsible, if you take responsibility that I will transform myself as a personality, you will be helped to transform your family too. This is the responsibility of an individual. Don't you think so?
I do, sir. I totally agree with you. So all those influencers, trying to be influencers, all those Instagram users with millions of followers, if you're chasing to be legendary, if you're chasing the status of being legendary, rather focus on life, rather focus on skills. You will live life in a better way. Sir, tell us, you think this world is beautiful. Of course you do, because you're beautiful inside out. One has to be beautiful internally to get that vision more clearly that yes, world is truly beautiful. So you know, what you see, what you feel inside, that's what you see outside.
Definitely.
Can you please tell us, how can we work internally? Because it's energy. I can feel that vibe with you. So how is it we can work on that vibe, that people around us feel that positive stuff? Yes, you are someone divine person. Yes, you are doing something great in life. Tell us, how can we work on our energy so that we get the vibe easily?
Wonderful, wonderful question, Muskan. I would like to appreciate you for your question. It was amazing question. Without connecting to ourselves, what's the use to connect to the world? Number one, if I don't know who am I, what's the use to know the whole world? So to connect to ourselves, we would have to go through the five steps. That is called self-love. We start to love ourselves. We start to feel that we are the divine essence of the divine. And the moment we start to feel that we are the divine essence of the divine, we start to develop the self-love. We will start to develop the self-respect as well. Then we will not crave for the love and respect from others. It will come from within. And when it will come from within, the world will start to love and respect us automatically. This is my belief system. So self-respect, self-love, self-esteem, self-confidence, and self-realization happens through connectivity with self. But the question was how to connect with the self. That's a $1 million, or I will say $1 trillion question. And the answer to this question is, devote some time with yourself. Sit with yourself and connect with yourself in that silence and ask yourself, what am I doing at present? Am I doing justice with my potential? Am I doing something where my parents could be proud of? Am I doing something my friends could feel the honor? Where I am just working, whatever I am working, like my family, my friends, my relatives, or the people who are just connected with me, they could feel those vibrations. Like, yes, he or she is doing in a great way. And to start to ask these questions, we call it introspection. The moment you have introspection, you will start to connect to yourself. And the silence will give you the power to connect to yourself. The biggest challenge which I feel because of my interaction with thousands of youths, I just would like to tell you today, that they have fear of connecting with self. They don't want to sit with themselves. They just see everything in the external world. And that's the reason that they don't understand the power of self. Connectivity. They don't understand the power of inner world. And each and every individual, I have seen those who are the greatest personalities, those who are the greatest personalities, and those who will be the greatest personalities, they had one thing in common, and that connectivity with them, because they knew who they are, what they want to do, and what they have to do.
Oh, that's very energetic to hear that. I can feel that vibe again. But sir, the problem is, the way you said, the youth, it's very difficult for them to sit with themselves. They want to socialize outside. They want to connect virtually with everyone. But once if you ask them, go sit with yourself for 20 minutes, they are wandering. Things have pulled them. Attention, the world, materialistic world, of course. We can't blame them for that fact. But how is it we can spend time with ourselves? There must be a step we have to initiate with that. Meditation is a very overrated thing. Of course, everyone talks about that.
That's okay.
But tell us an easier way. We connect with ourselves. At the same time, our personality shines a little more brighter. Tell us the way we can work with ourselves.
Then I will love to suggest whomsoever are listening or watching this video that we have heard it several times, but we never thought of it, that the charity begins from home. And this is my research, that the environment plays an important role in an individual's life. What we are the product of five people that we are connected with. So I personally will suggest whomsoever they are listening to that start to make your home environment with happiness and harmony. Connect with your family like anything. The moment you will have harmony in your family, the moment you will have happiness and healthy environment at your home, somehow you will start to connect with yourself. What's the use of knowing thousands of Facebook friends if you don't have harmony with your family member? I would like to give you a beautiful story of it, the Leo Buscaglia. This was the greatest motivational speaker in the world, you can say. Whenever he was asked that what's the reason behind that he knows so much, what is the reason behind that he knows so much, and he used to get standing ovation during his speeches. And he was asked this question, what is the reason behind? He used to say that there was a culture at our home that every day at the night time on the table, means the dinner time, every day during the dinner, all the family members used to sit together on the dining table, and our father used to ask us this question, that what did you learn for the day? And whosoever was not able to answer to this question was not allowed to take the food until they learned something. Either they learned a word or a wisdom. That was different, but they had to learn something. And every day when he started to share his learning with his father, he says that I grew in such an enlightenment way that wherever I was asked the question, the answers came naturally. That was the beauty. So if a youth or anybody who wants to connect, this only way to connect is that connect with your family first. Have harmony at the home first. If you will not have harmony at home, how will you bring the harmony in the society? How will you bring the harmony in the community? How will you bring the harmony in the country? And how will you bring the harmony in the world?
Well, that was a wonderful story, sir. I don't know if you guys got the moral, but let me tell you, if you find meditation and all this stuff huge things to talk about, start with your family, take small steps, love yourself, love your family, share love over there. So the world needs harmony, of course we do. So sir, how important is self-love? You mentioned that already, but tell us a little more, because I love listening about that. How important is self-love to add that spark in your personality?
Self-love is important because if you love yourself, then you can love the world. Until you love yourself, how will you love the world? This is one. Second is, to love yourself means to create something. To love yourself means that I have so much love inside that if my brother needs it, my sister needs it, my mother needs it, my father needs it, any family member, it starts from that again, I will say, if they need it, I have enough love to spread. And the moment that love will reflect in the family, then definitely wherever your family members will go, that reflect in that particular society as well. And your family means that individual family can be definitely the source of inspiration for others too. But to develop that, you would have to create yourself. You would have to ask yourself exactly, what should I do to love myself, feel myself, respect myself, realize myself.
That's really something we should think about, because all those thinking about world out there, all those thinking about relationships to go out with, start thinking with yourself first. So there are way too many internal battles going on with people. That's why their personality is not sparkling up to that level. It's all about ego they are having, ki they're seeking out for validation. It's because maybe they don't believe in themselves enough. That's why they are getting affected by the criticism or appreciation. We shouldn't get affected by any of them, of course. But somewhere still they're starving for validation outside. When someone appreciates you, of course you get happier. But someone when criticizes you, you feel like the world is over. We shouldn't be affected by that. Tell us how we should believe in ourselves a little more so that we don't get affected by what people are actually talking about you.
Wonderful, wonderful. I would like to start with a beautiful quote for that. That when ego comes, everything else goes. And when ego goes, everything else comes. So ego is the one that kills again your energy, your power, your divinity. Ego. E here is called that energy. So go. The moment you are an ego, your inner energy go. Ego. So this is one of the things I would like to share. And same time, if you respect, again we will come to this, if you respect yourself, if you love yourself, then there's no need to get the approval from the world. Try to understand. Because if you don't have faith in yourself, doesn't matter how many people have faith in you. Try to understand this. If I don't have faith in myself, even the whole world has faith in me, it doesn't make any difference. But if I have faith in myself, even nobody has faith in me, yes, I can do wonders in that case. So here, we must have faith in self, and somehow faith helps you to dissolve your ego. And definitely, we must respect others too. So same way for you too, for everybody. We have to develop a faith. I will like to frame it instead of I with the we. I will say, instead of I will say here with we, that if we have faith in ourselves, even nobody has faith in us, still we can do something great in life. But if we don't have faith in ourselves, even the whole world has faith in us, we cannot do anything significant in our life. So this is the first thing, that have faith in self. Second, melt your ego so the energy will be within, and respect yourself and respect others too. The more you respect others, the more your ego melts.
But sir, still, the sense of ego is extremely strong. Definitely. And that echoes their status-driven life, basically. They think if they're having very good cars and houses and all those materialistic things, mm-hmm. they think they're successful. Mm-hmm. But actually, they're not. Mm-hmm. They want people to appreciate them mm-hmm. for being successful, but mm-hmm. they don't want to work for success. Mm-hmm. Tell us, basically, all of us, mm-hmm. how is it? You are telling us to believe in ourselves. We have to. Mm-hmm. But there must be a process. We can't definitely go like that and say, yes, I believe in myself. It's not so random to believe like that we should feel ourselves. Yes, we need that light inside. Everyone has it. We know that's the universal truth. Mm-hmm. But there should be a process. Maybe mm-hmm. the personality grooming training you're talking about.
Wonderful. You are at a very beautiful, you can say at the right time, you have raised the right question
that,
here.
That enlightens us a little more.
Very
so
true.
So you can brief us.
Please,
more.
please. You know that the personality cannot be created in just a fraction of seconds, but to develop or to sharpen that personality, to groom that personality, the experience can be generated in a fraction of seconds. In this moment, the moment you are listening to me, something happening inside you, it means that you have that spark to sharpen your personality. But here, very important, this is a consistent process. That first, if you really want to develop that self-belief, first you would have to develop that attitude. The way you think, the way you act, the way you behave. That is called attitude. Because attitude doesn't care where it is shaped in. The moment it is shaped, it becomes your behavior. So first you would have to work on attitude. Then we would have... So that's why this personality grooming is a continuous process. An overall grooming of a personality. It's self-belief is not about in one area that you are something. It's about that yes, I am going to be a personality in such a way where I will play the role of a contributor. Wherever I work, whether I work in an organization, whether I'm at home, whether I'm with the people, wherever I am, my presence will be the source of contribution, not the consumer. So in that case, we work on attitude, we work on behavior, we work on communication. Can you imagine the world without communication?
No.
Now you are taking my interview because they have courage to communicate. We are having this conversation because of communication. If you didn't have that dare to communicate, how would we be sitting over here? Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Then decision making. So how to take the right decision in life. How to put your enthusiasm into everything. You know? So this is the whole process. And we have structure training. You might have heard about, you already know. So we have a structure training for it, which helps the people to groom their personality. So they could help themselves, their family, society again. Then they can just contribute wherever they go.
So all those sitting there eating popcorn, watching us on your couches, come on guys, raise up your personalities, meet him ASAP, as soon as possible, meet him, let's groom our personalities a little more, we better do.
Thank you so much.
Sir, I feel we sense the energy before we speak to them. If there there are some people, we basically don't focus on them, we choose our tribe, we sync with our vibe, but still you have to face such humans around you. They affect your personality. Because if you are not aggressive, you don't react much in life, but still presence of such humans around, they make you react, which either ways makes your personality a little more dull in life. Maybe you don't come out as good as you are. So how to avoid such humans around and how to work in a much better way on your vibe so that you come out in a very beautiful way in front of the world.
Superb. This is one of the greatest reason that the people just don't feel spit and energy inside, because they are surrounded by such people only. So I would like to give you the power of five formula here. This formula works for those who are really initiating to make their personality better, greater, higher. So this power of five says that start to connect those five people around, those who are extremely positive, those who are extremely good, those who have that divine feeling, or you can say those who really, you can say in different way, those who really want to help you. How you can count those five people? That those five people are the people with whomsoever you meet, whatever the circumstances are, whatever the situations are, with them your vibrations, your energy will be always higher, because this is the whole game of vibrations. The moment you meet the people, you might have felt that sometimes you feel very low vibrations, some dull vibrations, destructive vibrations, but at the same time you meet the other people too, you feel some great vibrations, some energy. Yes?
Yes.
So this is, you can start count. I will personally suggest that you can be, you can make this power of five with like your father, with your mother. These are the two. And select three more people that whenever you are in whatever state of mind you are, they will always give you those higher vibrations. And be with most of the time with these five people, gradually you will start to see that all vibrations will be into that higher one, and then lower energy will not be able to disturb you. That's the beauty, that if you want to implement, just follow the power of five.
Rather, using your brains and choosing all those perfect dresses and shoes, guys, come on, choose your tribe wisely. We better do.
Definitely.
People are so obsessed with positivity, you know it. But at the same time, we know positivity elevates you. But at the same time, negativity is existing. It's neutral. Yin and yang exist for a reason. They coexist together.
Very true.
But the roles we have, the list, we keep it separately. Our heartbreaks, we being broke, we facing failures, and many more things we generally don't discuss with people. Mm-hmm. They play a huge role in our lives, right? Mm-hmm. They build our personality too. But is it only positivity who is pulling us towards a career in a better, successful way? Or these are the hidden factors, like our parents, they are hidden, but they are still supporting you. The same ways we should embrace them. Tell us a way to embrace, because this is something very common we all are facing.
Right.
Everyone is having heartbreaks and failures, and of course being broke. It's everyone, their hidden stories.
Right.
But tell us a way so that we move constantly, we have that growth in our life and still not get affected by those. Rather, we should embrace them as a beautiful part of your life.
Very true. And this is the right time to work on, because as the whole world, every individual around us is suffering, like we started with. They are suffering. Wonderful issue that you have raised. I would like to appreciate you for that. But before I start with that, let me tell you, definitely as positive thinking plays a role, negative thinking too plays its important role in life. How? That positive thinking with action increases the probability of your success, while negative thinking even with action decreases the probability of your success. That's the beauty. So the moment if you see that it is not a failure, it's a feedback either. And second, let me give you, it might be philosophical for you, but it's working in my life like anything. And this particular perception changed my life. And somehow, if you deeply think, you will too realize it, relate it, experience it in your life, which I often share with my participants who just attend our training programs. And they realize it. Yes, it's, it works. If God disturbs your plan, It means he wants to execute better plan for you. Number, and his plannings are far better than our plannings. This is one of the greatest things. Even Srikant Gupta, now in front of you, you are feeling he's always chill, life is beautiful, this and that. I too have lots of challenges and I too have lots of ups and downs. But the thing is that the belief, the values that have been created, like if he disturbs the plan, it means he's executing the greater plan for me. The moment this thought has shifted, so this is the whole game of shifting the mind. The pain and the pleasure is not in the situation. The failure or the success is not the part of situation. This is that the mind which you are feeding with. If you see as a pain through your mind, through your perception, you will just be broken. But if you see that this is the greatest opportunity to teach me the lesson, you will see it in a different way. It will make you stronger, powerful, and somehow peaceful inside. So we say in this way also, Muskan, that mind of the man is the man. If you change the mind, you can change the man.
Yes, that's true. Also, you said we have to surround ourselves with such kind of humans around who encourage you or who bring out the best vibe inside you, and all those finding those tribe, you can join his course for sure. We are having such mentor, my God. He's living around us. A human who is having all that positive energy which you are seeking for, try meeting him for once. I am literally having this pleasure right now talking to you. It's so amazing, sir.
Thank
Let's
you
wrap
so much.
Up this session with your three advices which every youth right now needs to understand, to sharpen their personality, to grow as a person, and to love this life a little more.
I will just say, it's not an advice, but this is the way that life should be. The first, start your day with all enthusiasm and feel that this is the live this day in such a way that feel that this is the last day of your life, number one. And second, learn in such a way that this is the first day of your life.
Perfect.
And third, live life so you could be an example for the world, not the warning for the world. These are the three beautiful suggestions to the youth, to the individuals who really want to create the new life. Thank you so much.
Okay, so that was a wonderful answer, sir. But I still have one more question. Although I've wrapped up the session, I still have one last question. Sorry, guys. People are judging each other like for no reason. Can you teach them how focusing on personality grinding process should be much prioritized in their lives than pulling others down? This is something...
I would like to give you the beautiful message, and in a short line only. Remember that success comes to those who willingly celebrate the success of others. So if any individual wants to be successful, and every individual wants to be happy, every individual wants to be peaceful, because life is an ecosystem and the universe is listening to us. So if we spread happiness, we will get happiness. If we spread joy, we will get joy. If we spread success, we will get success. This is the only philosophy. What you give in multiple folds, it comes back to you. So what's the use to share hurt? Or to spread hurt? What's the use to give pain to others? It is better to give peace, joy, happiness, success and hope to others. Let's start to appreciate the world for it. This is the message I would like
That's
to give you.
That's so beautiful, and I hope you all have received a little hope from seeing this scenario, the interview we had. The video was fantastic. The podcast was amazing. I have still many more questions to him. If you loved the series, we are going to continue this. Thank you so much, sir, for coming here. It was a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Mr.